just how much meta in the top tier decks can we shove into one top eight? Well, I got the answer for that for you guys. The Ghost Corp Championship Breakdown is here from this past weekend, guys. And, of course, 34.8% of you have not smashed the blue crap that subscribe button. Come on, smash it so we can get to 100K. This is the highest representation of meta that I've seen kind of congested together in such a large volume that it's actually pretty interesting to me. So the top eight for this breakdown was very, very heavy represented in pretty much all three categories of what are deemed the top decks right now. We had three Tri-Brigade, and of course, the interesting part about these lists was these lists were focusing on playing all sorts of combinations of things from DPE to just standard bird stuff. You know, the fact that this deck can now do so many more things from like DPE to the bird package to standard try, and then like even on like the lower spectrum here, you can mess around with like Melfi Brigade. In terms of just so much diversity for this package that it's actually kind of insane. And this was also the same tournament where we had three Sword Soul variants in Top Cut, and of which two of these were this going second Mystic Mind variant that just looks very nasty on paper. Talk about you just go second, evenly Dark Ruler, Mystic Mind your opponent. We'll talk more about that here in a second, but those builds are particularly very scary in the regard of just being able to smash through and break those boards. And then we also had two Dragon Link here, kind of wrapping up the top 10. Dragon Link is going to be those players that tend to like know how the deck combos more. I would say more the big brain types of plays to do with those, because in terms of like top end for development for that deck, yeah, it's definitely quite big brained in my opinion. So let's pass on over to the deck list, shall we? All right, the first deck list we're going to be looking at from Top Cut here is going to be top eight. This was CJ Kraus playing what appears to be the version of Tri-Brigade that is putting in the Fusion Destiny package. Now remember, Bear Broom can give you a little bit of a consistency issue with this because Bear Broom locks you, and so can Fusion Destiny. Some hands you're just going to have to make the call of which one that you want to end on. And I guess like having that skill tree for the decision for what you want to do in terms of that is, I think, where a lot of players kind of struggle at this point. And while a few people are not super set on playing this, another friend of mine was telling me they were testing around that it was just constant brick after brick. But I feel like if you can find success with the Fusion Destiny package and Tri-Brigade, I think you're going to have just a whole lot better of a chance going forward here. So yes, one Tri-Brigade package straight away here, playing the Fusion Destiny package should give you guys a little bit of an indicator what's going on there. Next up for top eight here, we also have a Dragon Link list for you guys here. Now, I can't say that I'm particularly all the surprised about these ratios, considering the fact that we still have the two copies of Tidying and the one chamber hand-trapped out of our mind with Triple Veiler, the Triple Gamma, the Triple Nibiru. Gamma kind of been up in the air, I guess, for a few people this format. I see that Phantasmase found their way into the side deck for whichever matchups they really need it. Seed Monsters are kind of on the down low right now, considering that, you know, Sword Swirl's just like, I just want a Synchro today. Outside of that, there's nothing particularly too crazy that sticks out about this deck. Dragon Link has pretty much been fundamentally skeletoned at this point, and I don't really think you get a lot of like cool diversity and things you can really do with this. I mean, I keep making the Tidying jokes every deck profile. It's like, oh, well, these are our flex spots. They kind of really do feel that way at the end of the day here. So Dragon Link still continuing on, do what it does best. Next up here, we have another Tri-Brigade package for you guys here. This build playing 41 cards. This one also pulling a note out of the previous book here, playing Yield Fusion Destiny. See, we have double droplet in the main deck here. 41, but with the two revolt feels normal. IO in the main deck. I see that we have a one Zodiac monster in the side deck. That's kind of hilarious to me. So we board in the Ram and we're maining the Rat Pier and the Whiptail. So this is just kind of, I don't even know what you would call this. This is Zodiac Destiny Hero Tri-Brigade the deck with no bird package. Man, people really do be shoving some of the craziest homunculus engines in the world together. Now this looks like this would brick on paper, to be perfectly honest with you guys. That build kind of scares me a little bit. Continuing on with top 8 here, we had Hani Jawari's top 8 list. This is going to be your first look at the board breaker, as I'm going to call this. This is the going second, you have Droplets, Lightning Storms, Mystic Mines, Dark Ruler No More's here, and your opponent's just going to look at you in absolute disgust, because Tenyi being able to go second and function as a deck, and then just smash apart that board, set up their board, 99% of the metagame is not recovering from that scenario. So I actually think that we're a little bit further ahead of our time here, seeing this variant come out, and we'll have to wait and see. I do think that this existing in the format is going to be pretty much a threat for a lot of the metagame here, because once again, when you can break those boards that easily and then recover on like infinite two-card combos to start making these boards, that's not a fun time for your opponent. Especially like just one Mystic Mind can win you the game. All right, that just feels real bad at the end of the day. Next up here, going on into top 4. Top 4, we have another Dragon Link list for you guys. This one sporting off the 2 copies of Chamber and the 3 Tiding. 41 cards on this variant here. I see that we have the Sky Palace Prison down there as a target for us to continue up into with our big board plays. We also have the Cosmics in the side. Man, we have 7 Spell and Trap card destructions. I guess this deck does have issues with back row, and especially in like certain situations that you might not have like optimization here for that might be something to consider. And you know, I guess at this point in time you might be able to drop the, this is gonna sound really bad, you could drop the Cycle Readers, because clearly based on these tournament results there wasn't a single Drytron deck in Top Cut, so really what's the point in having them? Just kidding, I'd probably keep them in there just to be safe at this point. But another standardized Dragon Link list, another good day in the office, in my personal opinion. Next up here, the last top 4 list that we have is going to be, this is YMP Romans. This is pretty much the exact same thing here. We have the Board Breaker deck back at it again. The fact that this deck was able to advance into top 4 doesn't really surprise me all that much. I also wanted to give a quick little nod here. They are playing one copy of Blackout, I think, for this particular variant. One of the Icarus Attack clone is fine, and I do see that we have Protoss down there. I see we're also taking advantage of a pointer of the Red Lotus for that hand disruption. So technically, if you do have to go first, you can pretty much board perfectly, because you have the Ashes, the Drolls, and you can board in the Appointers. So you board out 10, 11 cards, board in the Veiler. So Transformation side deck, the way this looks. God, oh, the board breakers in the world. Does this deck not scare you guys? Please leave a comment down below and tell me, because that is not something that I want to find myself getting into a grind match with, because I feel like I just get blown out. Second place is Tommy Rose list. And this is actually what I've been messing around with this past week, kind of messing around with ratios and testing for when the earlier half of the week was for remote duels. This is pretty much based off of the earlier OCG concepts that we're messing around with. One tie in here is fine. The chalices are beautiful in this deck. And I just want to give a shout out to Raigeki right now. Unironically, Raigeki, Dark Hole are really good power cards this format. I don't know. Just the ability to clean sweep, negate something for free, counteract the opponent's board on the follow-up here, it feels pretty freaking good. Also, do take note that Tommy is not playing any Crossout Designators. We're just doing what we want to do. And then we are pulling a page out of Hani's book down here with our going second cards, giving us that chance to make sure that we can get to the scenario to do that. All right, so not quite as explosive as the other Tenyi variants out there, but we do have Vishudas in here, which is pretty standard for this deck. And then the deck walking away, the grand champion out of this event, was first place playing Bird Brigade. Now, out of the 3 Tri-Brigade variants in Top Cut, 2 of them were playing DP. This one playing the Bird package, so you'll be able to go through the double recital Starling loops. You'll be able to kind of do some of the crazier little interactions here. I see we're also playing the stupid Tri-Brigade trap card that basically is a free negate Onyx Ball trap card. And then, of course, we have the Harpies. The Harpies Featherstorms, which are insanely dumb value. So you can punish the opponent and set the condition on them. So Not a lot to say about this variant, but I will say that this build feels really, really powerful, all things considered. So, guys, what do you think about the breakdown for the Ghost Corp Championship? Please leave a comment down below what you guys think. And, guys, I will see your beautiful faces back here later on today with some more cool, awesome content. You guys stay safe out there. Peace.
Thank you, patrons, for making the ride never truly end. Without you guys' support, well, I would probably be doing Truffle Shuffle videos for a living. Guys, please check out VanCole40 for all of your Cardway Vanguard content brought to you by MCole40. And if you are looking to pick up singles, check out MColeGames.com for your trading card game needs. Thanks for watching, everybody.